Hello, welcome. In this video, we will see how to use Recoil State Management in Next.js. First, install Recoil by npm I recoil. Next, in the app folder, create another folder called Recoil and inside it create a paste.js file. Then, at the top, declare the use client directive. We need to do this because Recoil can only be used in client-side components. Now import recoil root from recoil and create and export a default function called recoil. Then wrap everything inside the return statement within the recoil root tags. But if we were to use the page router instead of the app router, then we will have to import the recoil root hook in the _app.js file and then wrap the entire app within the recoil root tags. Then we will be able to use recoil anywhere in the Next.js application. Now back in the app router, I will just add a title recoil state management. In the browser, check the recoil page. Now create a folder called atoms and inside it, I will create a file called string.js. You can name it anything you want. Now what are atoms? In recoil state management, an atom is the basic unit of state. It represents a piece of state that can be read from and written to by different parts of the application. In other words, they are like global states which are accessible from any part of the application and are similar to React's use state. To define an atom, we need to use the atom function provided by recoil. Export const string state equal to atom parentheses then braces. Then a key string state. Each atom should have a unique identifier that is a key. The key is used by recoil to manage and reference the state. Then a default value which is the initial value. Now create another folder called selector. Inside it create a file called string.js. You can name it anything you want. Now in recoil, a selector is a function that computes a derived state from one or more atoms or other selectors. Selectors are a way to create and manage derived state in a reactive and efficient manner. They are used to encapsulate the logic for computing state based on other parts of the recoil state. First, import selector hook from recoil, then import the atom string state that we created. Now we will define a selector that will give us the number of characters in a string that we will input. So export const blank state equal to selector, then within parentheses and curly braces, first give a key, and like atoms, selectors have unique identifier key that distinguishes them from each other. Then call a function called get, which allows us to read the values of other atoms or selectors. Recoil automatically takes these dependencies and updates the selector when any of its dependencies change. Now we will get the value of the string from the string state atom. Const length of string will store the length of the string and then return the length. After we have defined the atoms and the selectors, we will create two components in the recoil folder. One component will take the string input and the other will call the selector function and display the length of the string. In the input string component, first import use recoil state hook from recoil. This hook is used to write the value of any atom. Then import the atom string state. Now declare a function input string, and inside it first declare the recoil state. Const string set string equal to use recoil state within parentheses string state. The syntax is similar to use state hook in React. Define a function handle sense input set string e.target.value. This function will update the state with the values of an input field. Return parentheses div class name flex justify center to center the input field. Input type text placeholder. Enter the string. On sense, call the function handle sense input. The value equal to string. Now go to the paste.js file and import the input string component. Sorry, I forgot to import the atom hook from recoil in the string.js file. Let's do that. Okay, done. Go to the browser. Okay, the input field is displayed. Now we will create another component that will call the selector function and display the auto string. I will name it selectorOutput.js. In the new component, first import use recoil value hook from recoil. This will help us read the value of the atoms. Then import length state selector. After that, export a default function selector output. Inside it, declare a variable length equal to use equal value and pass in the selector length state. Return the length s3 class name margin obtain text center text large then length and save it. Finally, import the selector output component in the paste.js file. Let's try it out. Hello, my friend. Yeah, it's working. Let's create another selector. This time I will convert the string to uppercase. So export const upper state selector I will name the key upper state then get const string get string state const upper of string string dot to uppercase and return upper of string. Now import the uppercase selector in the selector output component. Declare a new variable upper which will take in the value of the upper state selector by using the use equal value. Let's check it out in the browser. Okay, everything seems to be working. I hope you like this video and I will see you on the next one.